Every girl needs to see this. Thin lips, thick lips, uneven lips. If you have lips and you wear lipstick, then welcome to Blush With Me and let's talk about lip liners, lipsticks, its importance and how it can help you enhance your lips and your appearance. I have seen a lot of women do this, including my mom. Just throw one lip color all over and out you go. If this is your idea of wearing lipstick, then watch me use a lip liner and see the same lipstick transform. Because the idea of applying any makeup or lipstick is not just to throw some color on your face, but to define that feature, to bring positive attention to it. If outlining your lips is new to you, then understand that overlining your lips, outlining your lips is like wearing heels. Heels can transform even the tallest girl's confidence. So can overlining your lips. For beginner's sake, let's start with the basic outlining and then let's master the overlining. Right now what I have on is Nude Lala Matte by Mented Cosmetics and now I'm going to use the exact same Nude Lala lip liner to define my lips better. Now you must have heard people say always use a lip liner that is sharp. Now the reason is not so that you can use the tip of it, because when you try to use the sharp tip of it, it gives you a very strong outline which is very hard to blend with the rest of the lip color and then it stands out. You don't want that. The reason you need to do that is so that you get good space on the side of your lip liner and then flatten the side instead of pointing it and just go on the natural periphery of my lip line. Now do you see, just by adding a lip liner, exact matching lip liner, how your lipstick looks more prominent. Now this is what my natural outline looks like. Now let's see how we can overline it to make your lips look fuller, more dramatic and still natural. Yes, I said overlining and natural in one sentence because most people are confused about overlining lips. They land up drawing way outside of their lips, trying to make their lips look bigger, and they land up drawing on their skin, which looks extremely unnatural. Once you draw your natural outline, think of this as your guideline to going right over it. And that's your perfect place to overline without getting on your skin. Like I said, this enhances any lip shape. So do super soft lip liners, like Mented lip liners. So if you're in the market looking for a good lip liner, then Mented Cosmetics has exact matches to their lip liners. Now, who has the time and energy to sharpen lip liners or to rub them so that they warm up and soften? Now, these Mented lip liners are super soft. Right from the get-go, they blend very easily. It's very easy to blend lipstick with it. It's very easy to apply it all over my lips. And they work great as a primer. Now, you can either use a primer before your lipstick and lip liner, or you can use a good lip liner to fill your lips. It helps to adhere your lipstick to your lips for much longer. And plus these Mented lip liners are roll-on, so you never need to sharpen them. Now I'm going to use the same lip liner and overline my lips. So feel the edge of your lips. This is where your lip liner should stay, not outside. Regardless of how much you want to overline your lips, remember to return to the natural corners of your mouth. If you don't, you will end up looking like a clown. Also, the left side of my upper lip is a little thinner than my right side. So I make sure I outline it slightly more than my right side. Same applies to your lower lip. If it goes way too much on the outside, your lips can look very broad and your smile can look broader too. This is one of the techniques I use to make my smile look narrower. Remember, you asked me about it in my last video where I talked about how I changed my ugly smile into the smile that I have now. You see how I'm going just on the curve of the outer edge of my lips, but not on the skin. So now they look perfectly balanced. Even if you're not going to wear lipstick, just a little bit of lip liner can really help define your lips better. Now, some women have symmetrical lips and some also have the edges of their lips very soft, meaning they're not sharp like this, right? So in both these cases, it's very easy to shape your lips. Now, someone like me, neither do I have symmetrical lips, nor do I have soft outline, and I have pigmented lips. So for someone like me, this tip is very useful. Use a little bit of concealer around the edges of your lips. This creates a very nice soft canvas. So now you can create any shape. Think about it. If I give you a canvas with some brown and black lines all around it and spots all over it, and then ask you to draw on it, how are you going to create an art? So first we create a nice neutral canvas. I'm again going to use the Nude Lala Lip Liner by Mented Cosmetics. Now this is the center of my lips. From here, I follow the natural shape. Liners save your lipstick from bleeding. They create a better shape, symmetry, and give you fuller looking lips. You could either use a lip primer or just use a lip liner to fill your lips all over. This helps to hold your lipstick in for much longer. Use a lip brush to pull the lipstick up to your lip liner and your lip liner up to your lipstick. Blend the two. Now, how do you select the right lip liner effects? Ideally, you should try to find lip liner that matches your favorite lip colors. Like here, I'm using lip liner and lipsticks, both from Mented Cosmetics, to show you how different shades of nudes, peaches, and pinks look when you wear them with matching combinations. You can also use a darker lip liner to outline your lips to create a completely different effect, as long as you blend the heck out of these two colors. Now, if you want, you can blend this pretty in pink with a deeper lip liner. This is M5. If you watch my video on how to find your perfect nude lipstick, you know how to blend lipsticks and lip liners so your nudes don't look like this. Mented Cosmetics is very close to my heart. I've been using their stuff, I think, since they launched. It's a company started and run by all women. If you see their collections, you will not find all crayon shades. These are super soft, rich, buttery shades of nudes that women of every color can find appealing to their skin tones, especially women of color. Their every color looks good on me. So Mented Cosmetics said, damn, this girl looks fine in all our colors. Let's sponsor her video. So thank you, Mented team, for sponsoring this video. And one of you lucky viewers is going home with a giveaway from Mented Cosmetics. On my Instagram, I'll show you all the colors. You just have to name which one is your favorite in the comments and tag a friend who would look stunning in Mented Cosmetics. So head to Instagram now. My handle is blushwithme_Parmita. If you like my today's whole look, then I am a Mented girl from head to my chin today. My eye makeup is done with this Mented eyeshadow palette. I'll make sure to post this eye makeup tutorial on my Instagram, so make sure you catch me there. Also, this brown and rougey nail color that complements my whole look is also from Mented Cosmetics. I was at my nail salon getting my nails done. I used this color and the girl was in awe of this. She said it is super pigmented. Just one coat was enough for her to get that full, rich feel of that nail polish. So I'm excited to try all their colors. And of course, I'll keep you posted on Instagram. To make sure this entertainment keeps coming your way, keep watching my videos every week, because there is a new video every Thursday. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell next to subscribe button, because then you can see me every week. Also hit the like button. It takes you a few seconds to write a comment below. Just let me know if you liked today's video, what you liked about it and why. A big transfer resistant kiss until you see me next week. Blush with me.